Hi, my name is Tim Jacobison. I did my project on design of a lawn mower that has the ability to automatically raise and lower its blade height. Lawn mowers are used the world over, basically for yard maintenance, domestic and commercial premises. They can be extremely dangerous. Blades rotating up to 4,000 revolutions per minute. Through advances in technology, we're starting to see more and more automated robotic lawnmowers that basically have the ability to be programmed to go mow a certain area at a programmed interval. So it's basically starting on the idea of blade height, automatic blade height adjustment. I've gone with the real blade design. It's sort of a rotary cage that spins. And I was sort of going to test this idea by constructing a prototype and carrying out tests from there. Motivation behind this project is I hate mowing lawns. Me personally, I spend 2 hours every fortnight mowing my lawn. That ends up being over 50 hours every year, which is about 2 days worth of mowing every year. Automatic height adjustment on existing automated lawnmowers doesn't really exist. Basic models have mechanical levers that the user has to set the height of. The more expensive models have electronic height adjustment, but it's not yet really automated. So at the start of the project, I sort of did a bit of a mind map to, I guess, break down what I thought the major areas were for automated height adjustment. I came up with the blade design, the raise and lower mechanism, and the electricals and control. So for the blade, I was just sticking with the real blade design. It's basically that style of blade with a stationary blade that it cuts with like a scissor action of the grass, and it's claimed to provide a better, cleaner cut of the grass, and that's why it's the blade of choice for golf courses and bowling greens. For the raise and lower mechanism, I was basically, for the prototype, I was getting most of it 3D printed. So there's going to be linear guide rails that the blade will slide up and down on. The blades and the blade frame were all going to be 3D printed from ABS plastic. There'll be a platform here for a DC motor to sit to, that will be geared to the blade itself to spin the blade. Again, for the prototype, I was going to use CD-ROM stepper motors as the linear actuator, and then had coupling 3D printed to couple the motor to the blade that would drive the linear actuators. So for the electrical side, I was basing the control on an Arduino Uno just because it's a really simple sort of microcontroller to use for a prototype. There's plenty of online support. It comes with an abundance of sensors. For example, I'm using the HCSRO4 ultrasonic sensors as to detect objects in front of the mower. The stepper motors, as I just mentioned, and I was using an A4988 stepper motor control board to interface the stepper motor and the Arduino, so it's really simple control. Just pulse two signals, one's step, the other's direction. So the step, it just uses pulses, so every pulse turns the stepper motor up 1.8 degrees. So that works out to be 200 steps per revolution. So it's pretty good control, pretty accurate. Manual raise, lower push button for the user to actually manually set the height, and limit switch. For control, I just used programming an Arduino IDE. It's just a real simple sort of programming platform. I wrote a preliminary program that I'm still yet to test, but it basically goes along the lines of, so power's applied to the board, and it'll raise the blade up to the fully raised position where it hits limit, and then the user comes along and will manually set the height using push buttons, and then while it's off mowing, it's constantly detecting whether there's an object in front of its path. If there is, the blade will raise to the fully raised position or to the limit, and it'll just wait couple of seconds, detect whether there's the object still there. If it is, it'll just wait another couple of seconds and it'll just continually detect. And when the object's finally gone, it'll go through the timer again, and then it'll decide to lower the blade back down to the original height and then continue detecting for objects. There was going to be a software low limit, so no physical limit switch for the bottom. I was just going to count the number of pulses sent to the servo motor, so sort of a form of open loop control, I guess. No feedback. And that will sort of limit how low the blade can get so it can't hit the ground. I constructed a prototype. 3D printed the blades, and I sort of started assembling it. It isn't completely finished yet, but that's it. I've got a short little video of the mower moving up and down. It's pretty quick. I'll just play it again. It's just one of the sides moves, just using the push buttons at the moment. So it's been somewhat successful. The preliminary prototype has been produced. Semi-functions at the moment. The overall concept, I think, has sort of been proven that it's somewhat legitimate. The I/O interfacing's all working correctly, though I've still got to finish the prototype and test it all together. Not so successful components have been, well, the prototype isn't complete yet. The program's still yet to be tested based on a completed prototype. And the biggest problem I've had, the motors I've chosen just don't have the torque, or the way I've made the mountings doesn't have the torque to raise and lower the blade. So when I designed the couplings and CAD, I didn't take into account that the motors would sit either side and they'd be sort of mirror image, so this one is working all right, and there's only a 25mm sort of gap between where the screw is and where the main weight of the blade is, whereas this one there's a 45mm gap, so like I think it's the moment on the screw itself is just putting too much friction on the screw, but it's just doesn't have the torque to drive it. So where to from here? I've got to redesign how the motor is coupled to the blade. maybe whether that's printing of new couplings or somehow attaching it. Yeah. I've still got to solder the electronics to a breadboard, complete the assembly prototype, and then finally test the program. Other ideas, other areas that would be worth studying to complete, I guess, the whole automated lawnmower package. Navigation, I read a lot on a few articles, people have started investigating machine vision for navigation control, which I thought was pretty interesting. The use of a camera on the mower where it relays the information back to a base station. And they compute whether grass is detected or the colour green, or different people use different things. And obviously GPS, that's sort of an obvious one. Grass length sensors. Another part of study could be obstacle and collision avoidance. This sort of exists on most sort of upper level automated existing lawnmowers. Just basically ultrasonic or infrared sensors already used to reroute navigation if an object is detected. So in conclusion, it's somewhat a semi-functional prototype, but still needs a bit of tuning to be a complete success. I believe that with a bit of tuning, it will work. But it set the foundations for hopefully next semester. The ultimate goal, I guess, is a completely automated lawnmower that just really minimises the human interaction.